again, YouTubers. So I am sitting down today to do a review for you guys on the Lancome Juicy Shakers. They are new. They are a pigment-infused biphase lip oil. This is what the packaging looks like. It comes in a nice silver packaging, pretty little, you know, embossing right through here, the name on the top. You open them up and they are actually, and it looks like it's separated. That was my first thought when I saw this. But it is actually a little shaker, and it is the oil and the pigment mixed together that you want to shake up to then have the product. I was sent the whole collection, and then there's also a limited edition collection as well. So what I'm actually going to do with that is I am keeping 7 of them. This is the one I have on today. It's called Show Me the Honey. I will show you what these look like. When you open the shaker up after it's been shaken, it is a doe foot, kind of pointed, soft, squishy applicator, and it is very easy to apply. You simply shake these up. They say shake them up to 5 times. I'm sure I've done more. I'm not sure more won't help. And then you can apply them a few different ways. You can apply it just at your Cupid's bow for a little bit of additional color, and I think I went above mine there. Or you can apply it all over your lips without lipstick, or today I just have on a lip pencil is all I put on. And these are the softest, most comfortable things ever. When I first saw them, I remembered that they had Juicy Shakers a while back and I liked them, but I don't really remember repurchasing them, anything like that. I had purchased them back then. And then my next thought when I started reading about these was I thought the YSL Tintin Oil. And if you've tried those, and I really liked those for a while, this is nothing like that. I'm gonna go through and tell you a little bit about them, and then I'm gonna show you some of the colors, and then I'm also going to do a giveaway with 8 of these items for you guys. So stay tuned at the end for that. Give you a little bit of Lancome's description of these. It is a lip oil with a pillowy cushion applicator, a shot of color with a hint of shine. I think it has a good amount of shine. It is the biphase technology, which is 2 phases. The first is a transparent oil, which is comfortable and non-sticky with the shine. Then the second one is a pigment for a shot of color. So if you're wearing them alone, you can get a little bit of color from them. The shaker is like a cocktail shaker to mix the pigments and the oil. And actually, when they sent these to me, it's super cute. They sent me an actual drink shaker with candies filled in it for like their display, which is super cute. And I actually have this here in my office now. The product has 4 nourishing oils in it that act like a lip balm. Now, I had tried, as I mentioned, the YSL Tintin oils, and those I thought were going to be like a lip balm. However, those dried my lips out really bad and almost stained them too much to the point that it got dry and kind of settled into fine lines. And so I actually stopped using those for that reason. This, however, is very soft, very comfortable. These are super easy. I just toss them in my pocket when I'm on the go and they're great. They've kind of replaced some of my others that I used to just toss in my bag, which is really awesome because that doesn't happen very often. It does have 4 nourishing oils in it. The first one is a peach kernel oil, which is a well-known emollient to soften your lips. There's sweet almond oil, which conditions your lips. There's a cranberry oil, which is rich in antioxidant properties. And then a muscat rose oil, which is rich in essential fatty acids, which helps to smooth out your lips too. So when you're wearing this, you're not just getting that little bit of color or shine. It's actually working with your lips to help keep them healthy and radiant. And it really gives you such a nice feel. As I said, they're not sticky at all. They are ridiculously smooth and they're so comfortable. They say, as I mentioned, to shake them up to 5 times. I guess they're saying 5 is the minimum, I would assume. You can tap it onto your lips, you can apply it over to a lip gloss, or you can put it in your Cupid's bow. Some of the benefits that they mention are 95% felt the texture was soft on these. 89% of people felt that it was not oily, which is true. It's interesting because it's not sticky and it's really smooth feeling, but it doesn't feel like greasy, oily. It's really just easy to wear. 84% felt that the texture was not sticky. I just said that. 88% felt that the lips were comfortable. as I mentioned, same thing. It doesn't get dry. It doesn't cake up. It doesn't cause any cracking or like uncomfortable feeling. It's super, super comfortable. 87% felt it did not dry their lips. Again, a product like YSL that I felt did dry my lips, this is the opposite of. 79% felt that their lips were more supple. I haven't noticed that yet, but I definitely feel as if my lips are softer. I wouldn't say they're more supple. They just have that moisturized kind of feel. 76% felt that their lips were softer, which is what I think too. You can purchase it at Sephora, Ulta, department stores, and directly through Lancome. It is $21. It is 0.22 ounces. The YSL, to give you a little bit of a comparison, is $32 for 0.2. Not much difference in size, but the difference in price is $11. That's a decent amount. There are 17 colors in this line, of which 10 of them are pink tones and 6 of them are peach tones, and then there's one that's blue. And I have a Get Ready With Me video where I actually put the blue one on over kind of a pink color, I think, just to see how, because blue is supposed to help brighten your lips and make your teeth look whiter, and I put it on that video to show you that too. The YSL only has 7 colors, and as I mentioned, that one kind of stained my lips and dried them out. Let me start showing you some of the colors here. The one that I grabbed for the most is this one right here, and this is called Show Me the Honey. It is a nice peachy tone. I will go through also and swatch these all together and show them to you at the end, but this one is Show Me the Honey. And this is how they come to you, okay? So you're seeing this one separated here. And this one is actually called Grapefruit. Great, as in something is great. And as you see, you just shake. You hear those balls start moving. And it mixes it up, and you can actually see the color of it there. Now, again, these are not truly the color that you're seeing here. They go on a little bit sheer and lighter. This one is called Lemon Explosion, which is a bright pink type of color. This one is called Vanilla Pop. Okay, so again, when you look at these, the names are more what is inside of them, or maybe the scent of them. Maybe that's what. No, they have a nice fruity scent, but this one is not specifically vanilla. This one is more of a pretty burgundy-ish color, like a mauve actually, more than a burgundy. The next one is Piece of Cake, and this one is actually really, really pretty with the lipstick, the lip liner I have on right now, so the Marc Jacobs Primrose. This one looks really pretty with it too. I forgot to put that one on. And next one is Berry Tail. Again, shaking them all up for you to see. Berry Tail is another pink color. I think I have a mixture of pinks and peaches. And then I did keep the blue one, which was Meant to Be. I am not going to swatch the 8 that I'm giving away, but I will show them to you. So this is Meant to Be, very blue in color. I'm gonna pull my hand, my shirt back and swatch these for you. Probably of all the ones, I love Show Me the Honey, Vanilla Pop, and Piece of Cake. So here are our swatches here. Starting at the bottom, this one is Show Me the Honey. This one is Grapefruit. This one is Lemon Explosion. This one is Vanilla Pop, which is a favorite. This one is Piece of Cake, which is another favorite. This one is Berry Tail, which I really do like as well. And then over here is the Meant to Be. Very, very pretty colors. I will go through and show you in the actual containers the other colors I have. This one is going to Kristen Game. It is the Juicy Shaker in Berry in Love. I want to send her one so she can give it a try out and see what she thinks of it and do maybe a review or show you guys these. Look at that pretty color. That one is gorgeous. So that one is going to her. And then I have these 8 others, which we're going to go through and I'm going to show them to you. This one is Boomerang, and this one is a very pretty bright pink color here. All right, and this one is Bohemian Raspberry. And we have Walk the Lime, pretty color there. So with these, what I'm gonna do for the giveaway is one thing, is I'm just simply going to choose one and give it to people. This one is PRS. I wonder if that's name. This one, this packaging is a different packaging. It wasn't a yet labeled packaging. This one is called Melly Melon. Another pretty pink. color there. Then we have Freedom of Peach. They have some cute little names to them here. Very pretty colors though. They're like, every one of these is absolutely gorgeous, but there is no reason in the world that I need this many of these. So I'd like to share Wonder Melon. So as I said, when I do the giveaway, I am not going to be doing specifically like, oh, I would like this color. Oh, I would like that color. I'm just going to at random pick Cherry Symphony, 8 winners. And I'm going to just simply pick one and put it in a package and send it to them. So, I mean, anything's great to try, right guys? This is another one that has an unmarked package. It's in the color Apri Cutie. Very pretty, bright kind of orange color. But again, and I don't want to swatch these because I don't want to contaminate them for the people that are going to be receiving them. I think that by seeing these swatches here, you can already see the pigmentation, and even the colors that look maybe bright or whatever are not particularly ones that will go on your lips that way. So those are my thoughts on the Lancome Juicy Shaker Biphase Technology Lip Oil with Color. I am absolutely loving them, guys. They are so easy to just grab and go and have with you. They are amazing. As always, I'm going to do my breakdown on thoughts on this product. Pigmentation, I would say pigmentation is about a 2 out of 5, only because of the fact of the matter that these are not meant to be pigmented. These are not meant to be a, you know, liquid lip color or a lipstick even. They are simply meant to be a oil with a tint of color. So they are what they are supposed to be. Next thing is texture. Texture on this is amazing. So smooth, so comfortable, so soft. Absolutely love it. 5 out of 5. Longevity. They don't last super long on your lips. You will need to reapply, similar to a gloss or a chapstick or something like that. You would simply continually put it on throughout the day. The same thing with this. So it's a 3 out of 5 because it's not like long lasting, but it's not wiping right off either, which is pretty nice. Application, they're super easy to apply. The only thing I will mention that I do think is difficult is once you have shaken it and you go and put the product on, put it on one lip, you need to shake it again a little bit to get more back on that little applicator in order to get the right amount of product. But they feel so good. And that little, that one smells different, it smells good. That little pillowy applicator is really soft and nice to put on too. So application's a good 4 out of 5. Packaging, as I said, the little like, what is this called? You know, like martini shaker type of thing is super cute. Super easy to grab and go. It is a little bit difficult for in your pocket when you just simply throw it into your pocket. It's a little bit, not awkward, but it doesn't sit flat. So, and it's just kind of how it moves. It's a little bit off. But packaging, I think, is super cute. So let's give it a 4.5 out of 5, only because it's a little bit difficult to put in your pocket. But it's smaller than a typical lip gloss, so it is a little bit easier. But the thickness makes it difficult. Color range, I think that's awesome. 17 colors in a lip balm type product with lip oils and beneficial properties. I think that's pretty decent. I think that's a good solid 4 out of 5. Price, as I said, $21. I think that's a decent price for these, especially considering $32 for the YSL one, and these blow that YSL one out of the water. They are really, really awesome by comparison. So good solid 4 out of 5. So product overall on this, I think it has a few little, you know, things, but nothing that's a major drawback. Like, I think these are really, really great solid product that they came up with. I love the concept of the oil with a tint of color, not a stain like the YSL. The YSL, that was the problem, is it stained your lips and it looked funny and it bled funny. These just give you that tint of color when you want it. It's absolutely beautiful. Good solid 4 out of 5. So if you are interested in these, don't forget to check them out at Sephora. Sephora has their VIB sale coming up, plus Friends and Family, I think, is going on right now. So if you are interested in these, now is the time to pick them up. Definitely check these out. Let me know if you have any other questions on anything I mentioned here. And so on to the giveaway information. All right, if you would like to enter the giveaway, simply comment below, enter me. Each person can enter one time. If you enter more than one time, obviously I am not going to count the additional ones. Don't bother spamming other people's comments. I still see them because that happens a lot with contests. And you must follow me, be a subscriber here on YouTube, and then you must also follow me on Instagram and like the photo that has the Lancome Juicy Shakers in it. That is the key. When you like that photo and you comment here, if your names are different, also on this comment, please put enter me and put both of your, obviously your screen name for YouTube will show up there, but also put your name that is Instagram, and that will enter you to win. I will be picking a winner on Halloween, and I will be contacting them on or around the first couple days of the month of November. Please make sure you are following me on both YouTube and Instagram. I will send you a message. I'm not sure on which one. So next week, make sure you're watching your social media on both YouTube messaging and Instagram messaging. That way you'll know if you win. I will also try to post the names of the winners maybe on a photo on Instagram. That way you're aware. And what else I am wearing. Today I kind of, not makeup-wise went fairly simple, but clothes-wise went fairly simple and jewelry-wise. Today, let's start with my makeup though. I have on the YSL Touche Éclat Blurring Primer, which I am buying with the VIB sale. I have on the Too Faced Born This Way Foundation, Tarte CC Corrector Under My Eyes, the Tarte, it's called like something tape, I forget the name of it, it's a new concealer by them. I couldn't find it at Sephora. Check your Sephora before you purchase, but I found it at Ulta. I picked it up at Ulta. I'm really enjoying it. If you like the Urban Decay Naked Concealer, give this one a try. RCMA powder to set under the eyes. Hourglass bronzer. I have on Laura Mercier Baked Matte Radiant Highlight 01 with NARS Madly Blush. On my eyes is the Anastasia Mario, something by Mario eye palette, which I am in love with. Again, another thing that was on Sephora's site, I was actually talking to Kristen Game about it, and I think that's where she bought it. I bought it through Anastasia, and I think she got it through Sephora because it was on Sephora's site, but now I can't find it. So I don't know if they just sold out or what. Anastasia Brow Wiz in Soft Brown with a little bit of just clear brow gel. I have on Makeup Forever Aqua Black Liner. I have on Lashes Are Ardell 105s today. I don't remember what the 105 is. I have a feeling it's like a Demi Wispy something. 105s. I have on my lips the Marc Jacobs Primrose Lip Liner. No lipstick with the two different shakers. Show Me the Honey, and I just put on a little bit of Piece of Cake, I think it is. Yes, Piece of Cake. I just put a little bit on. This one's going in my pocket now today because I think this one looks great with this. Let's see here. I have on a cute little shirt. This thing is so comfy from Free People. It is just amazing. It is perfect. It's got the holes in the hands. It's just so cute and comfy. I have on a pair of Hudson legging jeans, a pair of Converse slip-ons. I told you I was being super comfy today. Hair is tied up in a knot. I am going for a mammogram today. That's why I'm going comfy. Get your mammograms done. Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Oh, I have on these hammered hoops, guys. You guys know I don't like earrings like that hang. These hammered hoops are amazing. They feel like you have nothing on. They're absolutely amazing. I also have on my Covet initial necklace in gold. It also comes in silver. And then I have on the Eternity necklace. I absolutely love this with the yellow gold and the silver circles that kind of bend together and move easily. I have on the Maylee ring. I don't have on any bracelets because of the fact that I have on a shirt that has these that I love. And that is everything. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Please let me know if you have any questions whatsoever. As always, don't forget to subscribe, and thanks so much for watching, guys. Have a great day. Bye.